22nd, June 2016. This is Jupiter Stein Children. I'm going to conduct your speaking test. Can you first tell me your full official name?
Thank you. My full official name is Yasmin Azimuman. As you can see, it's on my passport.
How may I call you?
All my friends and family like to call me by Muman, so you can also call me by my last name, that's Muman.
Welcome, Yasmin. Where are you from?
I'm from Chittagong, a place called Kapashkula. It's quite about 20 minutes from here.
Right. You live in a house or in an apartment?
I live in an apartment. And that's also, that's in Kapashkula, and it's, I live on the 8th floor of the apartment.
Okay. Can you describe your apartment?
My apartment is, total it's 14 story apartment, and I live on the 8th floor. It's a very beautiful apartment with beautiful decoration on the interior and on the exterior. There are, inside the apartment, there are 3 bedrooms. There's a drawing room, there's a dining room, and a big kitchen. There are 3 toilets, and it's very well furnished and well decorated, and it's a very peaceful place and a very peaceful neighborhood to live in.
Yes. So, do you prefer sharing your apartment or you like to live on your own?
I like to live on my own because, like, I can maintain my own independence and individuality, and like, if I have to share, then I have to make lots of compromises. There might be some quarrels or sometimes misunderstandings with the person I'm sharing.
Do you think it is better to share a house with your friends or with someone you don't know?
I think it's better to share with friends because, like, if I know my friends, they understand me well. They'll know all my bad and good deeds. They know, and they can help me. Most important is, like, I feel sometimes shy or insecure with an unknown person. But if it's my friend, they'll always, in any of my bad times, they can help me. I'm sick, or sometimes even in my happiness, they'll share my happiness.
Right.
We share our things and everything.
Okay, let's talk about habits and routines. Can you tell me what you do on a normal working day?
Sorry?
Can you tell me what you do on a normal walking day?
On a normal walking day? Normal walking day, I have a daily routine.
Yes.
I wake up early in the morning, I have my breakfast, dress up and go for my university. And I go out of the house and take a taxi. And then I go to my university, and like daily routine, I take classes, I have to make my own lectures, then I meet my colleagues, and it's a nice day. I see my students, I feel good how they're developing in their studies. And then after the university finishes, I come back to home, then I take rest, and then I pass some time watching TV and with my siblings, and then that's
like. Okay, how do you like to relax after a hard day?
I just love to relax after a hard day. I take a long sleep of 7 to 8 hours at night, and like before that I try to have a good balanced diet and then refresh myself.
Okay, do you think it's a good thing or a bad thing for someone to develop routines?
I think it's a very good habit to develop routines because you know what you're going to do today, suppose. Like if I'm going to start my day tomorrow, I know what I'm going to do tomorrow. I have my routine set. Like, you know, routine wise, I can fill up all my works. I can do all my responsibilities and duties. Like I don't have to, like everything is planned. Like sometimes if I have to deviate, that can be in some like circumstances. But otherwise I know how's going to be my day. But otherwise like I won't be, if I'm not planned about my day, then like I won't know how to start my day. Like it's going to be a haphazard.
Do you have a bad habit that you like to use?
I have a bad habit that's I sleep a lot. Like I say, I sleep 7 to 8 hours. Like I sleep a lot. That's a very bad habit. Like sometimes when I have to do a lot of studies or a lot of work on the internet, I see that I'm sleeping on my laptop.
Right.
It's a very bad habit.
So let's talk about birthdays. How do people celebrate birthday in your country?
Like you know, my country Bangladesh is a very reserved country. Like this kind of celebrations are not that popular. But like now with advancement and modernization, many people are celebrating their birthdays. And like I think it's mainly family programs. And unless those of the elite class people, they celebrate it in hotels or restaurants. They have lots of people. Otherwise, it's.
Are there any ages that have a special significance in your culture?
I think there is not such age, like the middle age people. Middle means I think from 20 to 30 to 35. This is the age where people work a lot in my country. But and before that there is studies, and after like 40 there is bit is like they get in old age, but the middle years of life there is not.
So what are some of the advantages of getting older?
I think some of the advantages are like you can rely on your children after a long life of hard work, and after you get retired at an old age, like you have some time for your own, you have some time to spend with your old friends, then you have some time to watch TVs, and like you get to know your children, grandchildren, so it's very beautiful.
What are some of the disadvantages of getting older?
Some disadvantages, as I said, it's an advantage that you can rely on your children. Like this can also be a disadvantage because some children doesn't like to keep their parents. They may give in old, homes. Like they can send their parents somewhere else. Sometimes they have clash with their families. They don't like to listen to their parents, and nobody actually gives any kind of importance to their what they say.
Well, thank you very much. Now I'm going to give you a card. On the card you find the topic and also find some guiding questions. Based on that, you have to prepare for 1 minute and you have 1 minute time to think.